Jenna Thomas, and I'm a data and applied scientist on the Azure data team working on SQL. Today, I want to show you in a very short video how you can leverage SQLMLUTILS to do package management for your R libraries when you're working with Azure SQL Database. So let's go ahead and take a look. So before we get into the code, I just wanted to show you that SQLMLUtils can do package management, but it can also do things like create stored procedures in T-SQL from places like RStudio, and it can help you execute code in SQL. Okay, so now that we've done that, let's go ahead and take a look at how you do this. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go ahead and import that library, the SQLMLUtils library, and this just goes and gets it, okay? Now, the next thing you're going to want to do is specify your connection, and for the purposes of this, I just wanted to show you how you do it. So here I would supply the name of my Azure SQL Database logical server, then the Azure SQL Database name, and how I log into this Azure SQL Database. And once I'm connected, I can then go ahead and take a look at the packages I already have installed. And that's a pretty simple command. I just do SQL installed.packages and specify the connection, which is from here, and the package and just the various things I want to return. And then I can go ahead and return those. So let's run it and see how it goes. So now we can see it's returned all the libraries that we have within our R server locally within the Azure SQL Database. And what we might notice is in this example, we don't have a package called glue. So let's say we want this package called glue, so we want to go get it. So now with another very simple line of code, I can use SQL install and then basically list the packages. So we can see I use the same connection string, the name of the package I want to include, and the scope. And you'll see kind of what that scope means, but basically it's who do I want to have access to using this specific library that's using the database. And you can see down at the bottom, it's just authenticating and then downloading and installing those packages to my library. So once it loads, we can go ahead and run this same line again to see if we now in fact have that glue package. And so now that that's loaded, what you can see is that we do have the new packages been added, and it's actually added to a different place, external library sandbox public path. And you can see that the scope is public as opposed to private or system. So that's it, just a quick video to teach you how to get started with SQLMLUtils in R for Azure SQL Database. I hope this was interesting and that you learned something, and you can like and comment and let us know what packages you're using and what you want to see next time. Thank you.